Hello and welcome to the Timmy James Show. I'm your host, Timmy James. I don't give a fuck. I love that song. Why? Because I made it. I have announcements to make. Special announcements. Very special. Why are they special? Because they're about me. I don't mean to be selfish, but I'm just being funny. Because I'm a comedian, that's what I do. Speaking of being a comedian, on the 6th of September, I'll be performing. They've got at the Albion Hotel in Albury. They've been doing this for a long time. They've got open mic night. And it used to be just for music. But now, I just looked on the thing, Saturday, I'm pretty sure, Friday or Saturday. They do open mic stand-up. So, I haven't been on a stage in a very long time. So, I thought, well, what's the best way to practice and get myself ready, because like I eventually want to go to Melbourne and perform at the comedy clubs, but I'm not quite ready yet. I need more practice. So this is the perfect way to do it. So at the Albion Hotel in Albury, in Dean Street, it starts at 8 o'clock. So, if there's any of you listeners out there who are, and it's on a Wednesday night, so if you've got kids and it's a school night, don't bother coming. No, I'm kidding. So if you're in the area, come along to it. It's free. You'll get to see me. If you don't come along to it, don't worry, because in the next podcast, I film every performance I ever do. So, for this performance, yeah, I'll be filming it, but I'll play it on the next podcast. So if you're thinking, oh, I won't be in Albury, or oh, I'm not in Australia, don't worry, because you'll hear it on the next podcast. Now, the second announcement. I am currently setting up my own website. now. It's very difficult because, like, I'm doing all this myself, and I've got very little to no experience with setting up a website. So when this website comes out and you look at it, it's like, oh, it's very unprofessional. It was done by a 21 year old man with autism. So don't be too surprised if you're like, oh, doesn't look too good, and like there's all this and all that, like it doesn't look professional. Well, that's because I'm only on a pension and I can't afford to pay someone to make me a website, and I don't really have the courage to ask someone because I don't know if they're gonna do it for free. So yeah, I'm gonna eventually have a website where I'm gonna be making like special T-shirts with my mate, like with my name on them. Probably do. No, I won't be making comedy albums yet. Yeah, I've got all these different plans. It's just so funny, but like, yeah, I'll be making a website, and not only that, this is where you guys come in. On the website, there will be a button, like on most websites, they have a button where you can donate money. I'll have one of those. But it's not just money for me so I could get smokes and booze and other stuff. It's mainly gonna be so I can make the website better. And so I can also make the podcast better, like by getting like just like a better plan, because I'm back on that on air talent plan at the moment, where I can only record for 45 minutes, but most of my episodes only go for 22, 23 minutes. So that's not really a problem for me, but like if I want to do like a special episode or whatever, or if I just want to ramble on like I'm doing now, yeah. Yeah, it's just fucking crazy. I've got all these different plans, and yeah, I'm excited about going on stage again. I'm very nervous because I don't know what material I'm gonna use. It said on the thing on the that it was kid friendly, but school holidays haven't started yet, so I doubt there'll be any kids there. And if there is, because it starts at 8 o'clock, most kids, like, yeah, there'll probably be some like 15, 16 year olds there. That's okay because I can swear in front of them. But like the album might not like that, so I'm gonna try and keep my material as clean as possible. But yeah, like I said, if you're in the area, come along and see me at the Albion on Wednesday night. Yeah, so it'll be interesting because, like, last time I went on stage after I hadn't been on stage in a while, I just rambled on for a fucking long time. Like, usually when I go on stage, I'm up there for at least 5 to 6 minutes or whatever. But like when I got out of hospital after having my gallstone operation, I went on stage at the Albion, And I was on stage for almost 11 minutes. Now, not only was that the longest time I'd ever been on stage doing stand-up, I went a bit overtime because they even gave me the fucking light. Because, like, if you know about comedy clubs, they have that red light on the wall where you press it, and that light is basically telling who's ever on the stage to get the fuck off the stage because their time's up. Now, I saw the flashing light. Now, I had only just gotten out of hospital, and like it didn't sink in. And I had all the people tell me, come on, Tim, wrap it up, wrap it up. And yeah, I wrapped it up and yeah, it was good. I could actually, if you want me to, well, you don't really have a choice because it's not like you can call in and request or whatever, but you can if you want to. Or like leave requests on like Facebook page or email me for anything you want to hear. I'll play it. But no music or anything. Okay. What I'll do is I'll add. Well, I won't tell you what I'll do, but like. Okay. Return to me, James. Okay, without further ado, here is the gig in question where I got the light for the very first time. And it's a historical gig for me because it's the first time I'd ever made any drug references. And this is before I was a stoner. And yeah, it's just very different for like the kind of comedy I was used to doing, because I was usually doing comedy about autism. Now this is all about what happened during the time I had the gallstones and when I was getting them taken out. And here it is.
I don't know how to follow that. I'm Timmy James. I was supposed to be here last month, but and it was going to be my 21st, going to have this big gig on my 21st, and then, the Sunday before it, it was the NRL Grand Final, and my ab was sitting around. I had a pain in my chest, or it was like in my stomach, like in the, I don't know where it was, somewhere around there. I'm not a doctor. Sorry, I was there. I was sitting around with with the pain in my stomach, and I just couldn't take it anymore. I went in the dad, I'm like, can you take me to the hospital? And he's like, he's weighing up his choices. He's like, do I see the sharks wing or do I take him to the hospital? And I'm like, come on, Dad, I'm your fucking son. The Sharks will probably win, no matter what. But I don't know, I don't really follow the rugby, but he's probably looking at me right now and going, Tim, it's rugby, but he's not rugby, and I don't care. So I went to the hospital, and I found out I had gallstones. So I was in there, sorry to depress you guys, I don't know it's a comedy night, but my brother, just there to get this off my chest. So I'm there in hospital, and I'm thinking, like, they're talking about having taking my gallstones out, and I'm thinking, yeah, all right. So I'm in Wodonga Hospital for a night, like, in emergency, and I go to Albury, I have a MRI, and, like, I'm there, and they take me into the MRI, and they gave me something beforehand, just in case I freaked out or, like, threw it. So they gave me like some tablets to like cool me down. I don't know what it was, but it was good. So Yeah, and they were giving me all this other stuff as well for pain medication, so I'm like, yeah, living a rock star life in hospital, this is great. You gotta do heroin, and they're like, nah, so fuck them. So I'm there, I'm having the MRI, and they're telling me what they're gonna do, and my bad number and MRI, and they just said, hey, tell me, all right, we're gonna give you some headphones that you can listen to music. And I'm like, well, I wouldn't have taken the medication if I knew that was an option. So I'm there, I'm listening to the music, and they're like, what music would you like? And I'm a huge Beatles fan, as you can tell by the t-shirt. So I'm like, have you got the Beatles? And they're like, yeah, we've got the Beatles. So I'm there listening to the Beatles. And I've got Dad behind me, and he's singing along, and I'm like, did you hear anything? And he's like, my headphones aren't working. I'm like, what is this? I'm like, why are you singing? And he's like, I can hear it coming out of yours. So he's sitting behind me while I'm in the MRI machine. I'm just like, hearing all the noises going on, and the music's playing. I'm like, they've got the whole Abbey Road album playing. And I'm like, oh, this is great. But they should have told me about this, but anyway. So I get out of the MRI, and they tell me I have to go to Wangaratta to have their ERCT. Now, an ERCP is basically like they get a tube and they go down their throat and they just basically play, like they pretend they're fishing and they fish the balls down out of your throat. So they go in and like the doctor's explaining everything to me, and like I just wish he would have been more calm about it, because it sounded like I was getting operated on by Steve Irwin. Come in, he's like, right, all you're going to do is we're going to get this fucking tube, right? We're going to put the tube, we're going to get it right there in the throat, suck the balls down there, and it's going to go like that, okay? So like, what we're going to do, I'm just going to let you know now that the risk of this not working is very unlikely. So they take me in, they give me the operation, I come out, I'm just waking up from the anaesthetic, they wake me up, hello Tim, you alright? First thing they'll say when I wake up, they're like, hello Tim, and I'm like, Ozzy Osbourne. And they're like, why are you talking about Ozzy Osbourne when you wake up from a shunker? I'm like, I don't know, I was listening to Black Sabbath the other day, I was out of it, so I didn't really know what I was saying. So I'm there, and they get me out. And then the doctor comes, the Steve Irwin doctor, we'll just call him Doc Croc. So Doc Croc came in, he's talking to me, and he's like, you know how I said the chances of this failing is very unlikely? Well, I've got something to tell you, it failed. And I'm like, well, that is likely. Why did it fail? And he's like, I don't know. And I'm like, you told me it was unlikely. So I'm suing you, and there's nothing to do about it. So I go back to Albury, where I'm staying, in the Albury Hospital, and I'm there, and I'm just feeling very depressed, because I'm like, oh, this really got this label saying that he was hurting. And then, like, I had this gig coming up, and I was thinking, like, I hope they get these gallstones out before the gig. And I said to the nurses, I'm like, if you don't get these gallstones out, I'll get one of those tube things and I'll suck them out myself just so I can escape from the hospital coming here. And then, like, I'm just there laying there, I'm depressed, and like, I'm thinking, and I bought the, like, I rented the TV, and I'm like, what's the most depressing movie in the world? To have Batman be Superman playing, so I'm like, that'll do, that's the most depressing movie in the world. So I'm there, and it's the bit where Batman and Superman are fighting, and he's like, Martha! So why did you say that? And I'm like, I'm in hospital, I don't need this shit. So I turn it over to see what other movies and stuff on. There's this one with Robert Redford is playing this news journalist. I'm like, oh, this is good. So I'm there and I'm just sitting there in the hospital, and then I get a call, then the nurses come in and they're like, we're going to fly you down to Melbourne. I'm like, that's good. And they're like, we've got bad news. It's on a Friday, which happens to be your 21st, and it's the day of your gig, so you probably won't be able to do the gig, and you'll be in hospital on your 21st. And I'm like, ah, that's fine. So I'm there, and they're flying me into Melbourne, and I've got Dad with me in the hospital, in the plane. And we have this paramedic on board who's Irish. And he's like, would you like a biscuit? So he gave us some biscuits. Like, he gave us some biggies, and Dad was complaining because he's like, I just got a Scottish biggie of an Irishman. How weird is that? And I'm like, yeah, so what? And he's like, you should tell me. So I told him. I told the Irish paramedic, and he turned around and he speaking at that, and he's like, you do realize that seat there is an ejector seat you're sitting in. I can press this button any time and you could just go flying out the airplane when we're in midair. And I'm like, thank fuck. Because that's starting to piss me off. I'm like, I don't care if the Scottish, if an Irish guy's giving a Scottish biggie. I've got these fucking rocks in my stomach. It feels like I'm gonna die. I know I'm not, but I'm like, I'm in midair. I've got my, like, why can't they just do the surgery with Donovan? But they didn't. I've just got all this shit going in my head. So then I'm in Melbourne, it's my 21st, and I'm in hospital. Thank fuck they had a Wi-Fi. So I'm there, I'm on Facebook, tell everyone what's going on. And then my auntie comes to hospital, I'm like, yeah, that's good. We go to Melbourne, like we're in Melbourne, and then they let me out for a few hours each day. So I'm walking around Melbourne, and I was thinking I should just go get a haircut. So I went, got a haircut, and there was like all these different hairdressers like stacked up on top of each other. So I saw one that said, men's haircuts from $10. So I'm like, right, that. I went in and I went in and she's like, what would you like done? And I'm like, just cut a little bit off the top and a little bit off the bottom. And she's like, okay, that'll be $15. And I'm like, well, someone on the front says $10. And she's like, oh, you want the $10 one? I'm like, yeah, I want the $10 one. And usually when I get the $10, like usually when I go to the barbers, I get the $10, usually when I go to the barbershop here, like in Wodonga, I just tell them what I want and they do it. See, here, like in Melbourne, they didn't know what I wanted, so they're like, what number would you like? And I didn't know what number it was, so they're like, oh, I'll just have a number 2. And then they did this job on me. So I'm like, what the fuck is this? And she's like, you wanted a 2? And I'm like, well, thank you. Just paid $10 for the worst haircut of my life. And yeah, all right, thank you.
That was very cringeworthy. Like, I'm not proud of that gig. And for the record, I just want to say I never actually asked the nurse for heroin. Because I don't touch that shit. Like, the only drug I touch is weed, and that's about it. But, yeah, why the fuck? Like, I have no idea what was going through my head when I did that gig. It was, like, the worst gig ever for me, because, like, none of the stories that I was telling in that gig were very funny. Like, they were funny, but, like, most of them were just really depressing. Like, it wasn't a comedy night I should have gone to. It was a fucking shrink. But yeah, like when I was just playing that episode for you guys, I had to take the headphones out because I can't really listen to myself do stand up. Especially that gig, because, like, I just remember, like, I was a mess. I hadn't gone on stage in a long time, and my weight was a bit shocking, and fuck, it was just a crazy gig. A very crazy gig. Like, hold on, I was smoking weed at that point, actually. I was only smoking joints, though. I wasn't on the bongs yet. But, yeah, it was just a really weird gig, and that's all I just want to get across, because, like, I look at that gig and I look at that video and I'm like, what the fuck? Like, I look at that as a guide to what not to do on stage. Is ramble on about your fucking problems, which most comedians do, but they do it in a hilarious way. Now, most of that stuff wasn't hilarious, that was just me. Well, some of it was, like, I don't know what you guys' sense of humour is like, but I know that I've got heaps of people listening because I've looked at the statistics and all that. And yeah, I just don't really know what people find funny, and I won't really ever know, but, like, yeah. So, when I'm on stage on Wednesday night, I'll remember not to do that. Not to just fucking ramble on. But yeah. Just a fucking crazy gig. Now, I was thinking of playing you another gig, but I haven't got that in the playlist at the moment, and I haven't got any audio of that gig. Like, I haven't made an audio file for it, and I haven't even downloaded the video onto my phone, because it's what I'm recording on at the moment. But yeah, if you're in the area, like, if you're in Albury on a Wednesday night at 8 o'clock, come to the Albion and support me. Like, you can boo me if you want to, but I'm bringing a person there who, if you do boo me, she'll probably fucking beat you up. No, it's not my girlfriend. This is a lady who, she's basically a second mum to me. Like, the amount of stuff that this lady has done for me. Yeah, I'm always grateful for her, because she is the one who, like, alright, let's backtrack a bit. It is, I'm pretty sure it's like March 2013, I'm pretty sure it was. Or it might have been February, actually. I don't know. But I went to the Class Clowns comedy competition. Like, I hadn't entered it that year, but I went there just to check it out. Like, and this lady, I'll just tell her name, Judith. Judith took me to Class Clowns, but, like, before that, she'd actually sent me the application for it to try and sign up, or she's like, telling me, she's like, you should sign up for it, stand-up comedy. I'm like, I don't know. Because I wasn't really thinking of being a comedian. I was at the crossroads of thinking music or comedy. But then 1 year later, February 2014, I'll never forget it. Or like a couple of months before that, or it was most likely in January or whatever, I had entered in, like, I put in the application for Class Clowns, and I got in, and like, well, it's a competition, but yeah, I entered it in, and I'm like, thinking, this is interesting, like, because I did this one stand-up gig ages ago, fucking 10 years ago now, and I've never really spoken about it, and the people who were there haven't really came up to me and mentioned it to me. But I went on stage and I wasn't even using my material because, like, I was just a young, dumb 11-year-old kid. I get up on stage and I'm doing Carl Barron jokes. I'm like, would you care for an orange juice if it needed me? Like, all that. Because Carl Barron was my favourite comedian at that time. He still is one of my favourite comedians, if not my favourite comedian. Because he's the first comedian that I'd ever watched an entire concert of. Like, yeah, he's the first comedian who I'd actually sat there and watched start to finish. Him doing stand-up, like, on a DVD that me and my mum and my sister got my dad for Father's Day. And I watched that, and I just watched it over and over again, because this guy was so funny. And mind you, I was 10 when I watched this. 10. And yes, I was going around the schoolyard and doing Carl Barron's jokes. And 2 years ago, I actually got to meet Carl Barron. I went to one of his shows in Albury. And at this time, I'd only still done that Class Clowns gig. Oh, by the way, I didn't win. I got an honourable mention, but I didn't win. So anyway, I went to, like, 2 years ago, I went to this Carl Barron gig in Albury, and like, it was really good. I don't remember much of the gig because of what happened after the gig, because of when I met him after the show and I spoke to him. Now, I don't get starstruck that much. I only get starstruck if it's certain people, like, for example, I was very fucking anxious and all that, and, like, nervous, just meeting Carl Barron. I'm like, I loved him, like, I still love him. I have a picture on my wall, that, like, a poster on my wall, Carl Barron poster, that I look at. Like, it's just beside my bed, and I look at it every day. And he's the only comedian I have on my wall. Because he's not the only comedian I met, but he's the only comedian who... Well, he's the first comedian who ever made me laugh. And, yeah, I'm just forever grateful to him. And if I ever get to meet him again, most likely he won't remember me. Or he might. But, yeah, I just want to say one thing. When I went up to him and I told him, I'm like, I'm a comedian too. He's like, you doing any gigs? And I'm like, haven't really done a gig in a long time. There's not that many gigs here in Albury Wodonga. He told me, he's like, you better get back out there. And then cut to, I'm pretty sure it was 6 months later. I'm on stage. I hold house theater at the Glaber. Now, again, I hadn't been on a stage in a long time. For 2 years, as a matter of fact. That is a very important gig for me, and I will play that in the next episode, as well. But yeah, it's just, I'm just happy to be able to get back on stage again after all this time. Because I've got a lot to talk about. And I'm looking forward to it. So, anyway, if anyone ever wants to contact me, just look in the description and you'll find all my contact details. In the description of this podcast, like, you'll find all my contact details and there'll be links and all that, and like to Facebook and all that. And yeah, I'm Timmy James. I don't give a fuck. I'm ending this podcast right now. I'm not ending it forever. Just ending this episode. And yeah. Baby! The Timmy James Show. Yeah. Alright, I was going to play the theme song, but like you heard it at the start. Now, what I am going to play is... me doing the, I'm pretty sure I played this in the last episode, like, in the episode before this, but I'll play it again. This is a karaoke track, like, this is me doing karaoke on, because there's this karaoke app that I use and all that. It's called Sing Karaoke. It's by Smule. I'm pretty sure that's how you pronounce it. I don't know. But they're famous for the magic piano and the magic guitar and all that. And for the auto rap and the IMT Pain app. And yeah. So here it is, me singing Words by, originally by the Bee Gees, but this is Elvis's version. So enjoy, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye.
smile, an everlasting smile, a smile will bring you near to me. Don't ever let me find you gone, 'cause that could bring a tear to me. This world is lost in glory, let's start a brand new story now, my love. Right now, there'll be no other time, and I can show you all my love. Talk in everlasting words and dedicate them all to me. And I will give you all my life, it's here if you should come to me. You think that I don't even mean a single word I say. Take your heart away. Oh. Ooh. Steal your heart away. It's only words, and words are all I have to take your heart away. Heart away.
Not bad, was it?